Hey guys, my name is Moony. I'm a Live2D rigger and a demon VTuber, and I'll be doing some tutorials on this channel for Live2D help. I do take rigging commissions, by the way, so if you have a model that you'd like me to rig, just check down in the description below. I'll have some links, and you can check out my rates and everything. If you have a specific tutorial you'd like me to do a video on, just please let me know in the comments. So today we're tackling a more difficult concept, which is double clipping, and it might be confusing for beginners, so just be warned. So in Live2D, unfortunately, there's no support for regular double clipping, like how do you do it in an art program. There is a workaround, though. So I originally found this method through End on Twitter, and I'll have their post link below. But I'm personally more of like a visual learner, so I thought this might be a helpful video for other people. Draw order is very important for this to work. In my case, it's the jacket, and then you have the base of whatever you want the shine to clip to, and then you have the shine on top. Shine on top, and then it's the base, and then the jacket itself, right? And that is most likely how your model will be drawn, so we have to move things around a little bit, but that's okay. Whatever you want to have as the base, for me, in my case, it is the jacket here. And when it's normally on the bottom with the base and the shine being on top, we want to go over here in my panel. It might be different on your screen. I have my parts over here. And we're going to just, I press that and then shift click to select a bunch of parts. And just going to move this underneath. So it's going to look very weird right now, but just trust me, it's going to be okay. So now you have it. So you have the base, and then you want to have the shine above the shine base. You have the base that everything is going to clip to. The shine that's going to be on top of everything. And the base of the shine. You want to select the base here. You can't really see it, but it is the stars. And you just want to Control-C, copy, and select all of the base parts, which in my case is my jacket. So we have the jacket here. Click on Clipping ID, Control-V, Enter, and Invert Mask. So now you're going to have this. Now, reselect all your base items here. Control C like we did before. Go back. I don't know why I did that. And then select all of these. Clipping ID. Control V. Enter. And now, look at that. We double clipped it. Look at that. Let me move myself out of the way. I move myself in the draw order. What people normally do is that you turn the opacity to zero. So then the shine can really come through in its full effect, right? But for me, personally, I don't like how it shines through a little bit. So, I usually do about around 50 to 70 is usually what works for me. And I go to screen color, and I just flip to color match to whatever look best. We'll go for a nice little blue here. And then, yeah. Look at that. Double clipped and everything. Yeah. Anyway, that's how you double clip something in Live2D. So I'll have things written down in the description in case you guys need written instructions or anything like that. I know it will help some people. So yeah, if you're trying to achieve a similar effect, I hope this helped. See ya. Oh, I almost forgot. But I'm about to make a burp, I'm sorry.